Oh.
Good for your job.
Oh, the 90 man! Oh, they're spinning at the end here.
Look at this Sage and Dandar in the back.
Oh my god! Crashing!
And he's monetizing.
Oh!
Wait, I need to...
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the RSCRA. And today, we are here for D2 at Talladega. And ladies and gents, it is my honor to present to you Alex, the race winner, last night, flying all the way back home from London. Hey Alex, how you doing? How was the flight?
Hello. I like airplanes, so it was a fun time. Nice to get the win and sleep on the way home. Nice to be back.
Yeah, I was in that plane with you on the way.
Yeah, we were. Yeah.
We had some nice turbulence there over the Atlantic Ocean.
Uh-huh.
That was really bad. Terror's puking in the back, so. Anyways. So,
yeah, that guy's gross, so.
We're back here today for the RCRA again at Talladega. It's the AgPro 210 here for D2. And Alex.
I'm not looking forward to it.
Yeah, I don't know why I decided to stream today, but I did. Out of the kindness of my heart.
I don't know. It's honestly that Talladega, man. The races here are never the greatest. You know, to no fault of the drivers, they're all. Well, actually, maybe to some fault of the drivers, their own. But you know, what can you do? We're here to see some racing, and that's the 3 car of Terry going out to qualify. But yeah, we can just pray.
Yeah, that's really the only thing we could do, can we?
That's it.
Well, no matter what happens, the D2 always brings out some good racing. Let's be real here. I always enjoy the racing, even if it's not the best quality of racing, but, you know, I think it can be agreed that they do bring up some nice events here.
Yeah, I mean, no, this is a big racetrack. It's all about, honestly, I've never liked super speedway racing. Wow, they're really kind of cutting it close with cars, huh?
Yeah, there's a lot of cars on pit road.
Excuse me, just a moment.
Go ahead.
Sorry about that. Oh, yeah, you alright, buddy?
Yeah, sorry, I was having difficulties there. Trying to unmute, and with a loud family in the back over there. Oh dear, there is a lot of yelling. I'll be right back.
Okay. Well, obviously, right now we're going to have some... I don't know if Chris has muted the stream, but right now, commentary will be paused until he does get back, because I don't know who he's spectating, but yeah.
Okay, my deepest apologies, folks. I am so sorry if you heard my family in the back.
Yeah, not sure if you're in a slaughterhouse or.
Yeah, I just a lot happened right now. They're watching NASCAR and dear. Oh dear.
Did someone win the race? Was it the Mickey Mouse?
Yes, it was. It was the Mickey Mouse, unfortunately. After
he put
Corey LaJoy in the wall, too, so.
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious. He put LaJoy
in the wall. To win the race.
To win it.
Some people never change.
Right? Justin. Some
people never change.
Playing a bad name on track house. And you have died.
Do you need me to stream, sir?
Nope. We are good to go. I'm just trying to catch back up here.
Yeah, I mean, half the damn field qualified since you've last been here.
So. Apologies. But, can you update me on some stuff here, Alex? What have I missed?
Bill is on pole, Harry is second, Lucas outqualified Outery. But then again, it's a super speedway.
True.
You'll get back up on there track right now. The 10, who obviously has a sub. Who is Kevin Minion? I wonder.
That would be Charles.
Interesting. I assume he has seen
the Minions movie. He's the type of guy to show up. Movie. He's the type of guy to show up with the
with the suit.
With the suit. Oh dear. Yeah, over here and where I live, they banned the Minions movie from theaters in general. Like, just straight up banned it. Which kind of sucks, because I'm not sure
that's
if it's legal or not, because that's revenue being lost, but, who knows?
Well, sometimes things get banned, you know, it's just part of life.
As you can see over there, I believe that is... Is that... Super? Yes, it is Barry in 56. Is he on the outlap? Because he's on the high line, I'm not too sure.
I'm telling you the truth. Oh, here comes the 18. Oh, collision on pit road. What is he doing?
That'd be Rex in the money line scheme. Don't.
Why is he pulling out of the track? You kidding me, man? Oof. I tell you, took too long. Where is he going? Is this guy brain dead?
I still can't believe Chase Elliott just put Corey LaJoy in the wall and denied him his first ever win. That is unbelievable. Anyways, we're here in the RCRA where everyone gets denied a win every day of the week. So Alex, 6 to win Talladega?
I don't know.
Don't like to make assumptions.
I don't like to make assumptions, but you know what? You can't, because it's the super speedway. I was going to win... Okay, hold on. Let me rephrase that. I thought I was going to win Daytona.
Uh-huh.
And then, with like three to go, my teammate turned me into the fence, so you never know.
Hey,
we've had some really good finishes here. Almost every finish we've had at this racetrack has been a photo finish. The first one with me and Slaw and Cup last year. We had, I believe, you and Phil in trucks. So, if the package, it allows for some good finishes. But we got to get there first.
Yeah,
that's the painful part.
I sure do love racing here at Talladega. It's probably one of my favorite tracks, actually.
I wonder why.
I mean, I may or may not be like a 2-for-2 here, guys, but
are you? You didn't race here in Cup, did you?
Yeah. Unfortunately, I had to visit the elderly. I'm just kidding. I love you, Aunt Kay and Uncle Joe.
Self-plug?
Yeah, go subscribe to the YouTube channel. But, yeah, so... Definitely it's a nice track when you win at it, and there's cars on the track. There's cars on the track here. Phil's 12 cards is in turn 1.
Oh my goodness, have you ever?
No, I've never.
I gotta see if I can get that. What is wrong with these people today? Like, are they high? Mein Gott, man. I tell ya, I should have just not come today, should I?
No, because then I'd be lonely and ish. Yeah. And you don't want to make me cry, do you?
No. Yeah, <'cause... laughs> So, Chris.
Hi.
Coming out of London, okay. I want to talk about you a little bit here. You're Did you not pass Phil in points? Well, that's kind of shocking.
Yeah, I mean, he did the points, so I think it was kind of written. I was kidding. But, you know, it's a possibility. Let's not take that out of our minds here. But I thought I was going to do a lot better as Rex hits the blue cone there on exit of 2. And oh my goodness, someone has committed Dale Earnhardt in the 3. Can't spectate them, unfortunately. But, yeah, I did not pass Phil.
So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 automobiles. How many drivers today? You could count yourself, you know. 13, actually. You like to see the attendance here. This is my favorite part about summer. Well, other than like actually going out and doing things. But when you are inside and when you are home, you get those opportunities to do things like this. Now, I wish it was at a racetrack. Let's have a caution counter. How many cautions are we going to see today, do you think?
17.
I wonder what we got someone reversing down the pit road. Don't know who he thinks he is. I don't know the most cautions we've seen in a Super Speedway race before. I feel like it was probably Xfinity Daytona.
In the first race?
No. Xfinity Daytona, you know? The second one, was it? One that was this year? Got some interviews in and some info. Chris, your pit reporter says he has things to say. So
here we go, Coyle.
Hey, I was asking a couple people questions. AJ making his first start today feels like he can contend for the win today. He says it doesn't matter if people don't work with different people. It feels like. It doesn't matter if people work with other people. He just feels like if he can stick with other people and make it work, it's good. I asked Terry if he feels like the Highland's going to be a big factor. He says yes, it will play a big factor, but he feels like any line really can work today. And then I asked him also if today's going to be different because he's dominated on other tracks like road courses and intermediates. He feels like he's going to try to be more laid back today and try to put on a show for the fans. And then the final person I interviewed was Horse. He feels like he's just going to, in his first D2 start, he's going to just try to lay back at the start and try to work his way through the field, and he's going to try to work with his teammates as well.
Oh. Yeah, you know, it's like I said, this isn't particularly a track that requires a lot of skill, I would say. Yeah. So anybody can win. We'll see what happens. We gotta do some contingencies updates in this here booth. It's been a while, but that's the old Xfinity logo, huh? Yeah. But yes. This is kind of a hard qualifying to commentate because there's just so many people on the track. But you're top. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Your top 10. Phil on pole. Looking to take his first pole of the season, I believe. Then you got Terry, Horse, Lucas, Addery, Rex, Captain Z. I think that's Barry. K-Dub, Chris ATM, who is not very good. and Chairman Mao. So you got the two truck drivers qualifying at the very, very bottom of the field. Then again, Chairman Mao, I believe, is still qualifying, so I'm sure he won't. I'm sure he might, maybe will improve. Lucas, though, is somebody to keep your eye on. He got it done in the first race of the season, Daytona Super Speedway, Daytona International Speedway, excuse me. How do you feel? Well, listen, I hate to break. I think he has the most super speed. Listen, I don't know how he wins. I think he's just lucky. It is a full throttle racetrack. No, he did not. No.
He qualified after, but he DNF'd after the first one.
Which is a shame because Dames actually has Dames can contend for the playoffs here. And he just lost good points there. The good thing for Dames is
we've lost Alex, folks.
The good thing for Dames is
and we've lost him again.
Is that Josh also did not make the race and he didn't have a sub. So I was checking my points here. So Dames is less than 10 points away from Josh. So that's something to watch. But talking about Xfinity, on the topic of Xfinity, Phil raced Xfinity last season. Do you mind if I interview Phil?
No, yeah, go up, man. Bring him in.
Okay. Hey, Phil, it's the guys in the booth. You got us. Maybe.
He's probably strategizing with his crew chief at the moment.
Let's
bring him up one more time. We'll try one more time here.
Let me readjust my radio cord here. Phil. Hey, Phil, it's the guys in the booth. You got us this time? Maybe? Did he just leave?
Yeah, I think he might have been kidnapped.
I think maybe he's having some audio problems on that number 12 TRD. Maybe they poured all the funds into the Cup team. Now their Xfinity team has no radios. Okay then, how about we talk to Lucas, maybe? I think. Been a while.
Yeah.
Let's have a little chat with Lucas. Hey Lucas, it's the guys in the booth, you got us?
Yes.
So, the last time we went to Super Speedway in Xfinity, you reigned victorious, taking the win at Daytona International Speedway. I was saying that you're not a bad person to put a bet on when it comes to Super Speedways. You actually somehow managed to be there at the end. How are you feeling today? You're qualified okay. Obviously, it doesn't matter where you qualify at Talladega. But how are you feeling today? Do you think you can make it 2 wins on the season?
I actually feel like I can make it 2 wins in the season because at the same time, I got a win at Daytona. I just have to keep the same line and stuff like that and not make that much mistakes.
Yeah, you're actually not doing bad at all this season. You're 5th in the championship, leading all of the Fords, all of your teammates. 80 points, 5th. I mean, you're in the playoffs. You're one of 4. You're one of 3 cars that have actually secured their way into the playoffs. So, I mean,
yeah,
you're not doing so bad. What for you this season? Is it just being consistent? Would you say?
It's either it's that, and also with stages, because I may not do that well in like the final stages. For example, what was it? Indy, I thought I was gonna do good in that. Maybe got a top 3, but it wasn't that good. But the stages were awesome, so I think that's what's helping me out.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, you know, new scoring points format this year, helping some people out. Well, I wish you the best of luck. Honestly, I wouldn't be mad to see you win. I think that would be pretty interesting.
Can I ask a question?
Oh, sure.
So, Lucas, with the unfortunate race for yesterday, of course, in London, Do you think that impacts your confidence today, or how are you doing after it?
It doesn't impact it, because at the same time it was like I wasn't being myself in that, because before that race I had a problem going on in my house. So it was like it was pretty weird. So like I didn't feel like myself that race, but right now I feel confident as ever. I'm not worried about a thing.
Thank you, Lucas.
Thank you, Lucas. Well, good luck on your race. I hope to see you again at the end of the race in Victory Lane, hopefully. Good luck.
Thank you.
That was Lucas, driver of the number 23 Northern Motorsports Ford. You know, for a lot of people don't like Lucas's driving style, but I think he's actually been better off this year. Started in Cup. Really, he didn't start in Cup. He got called up to Cup. He got put in a car that had like 0 points, 100 points back. And he tried. He did try.
Alex, I have a question. Who set a time first, Chairman or Zaki? Because they're both tied for
Zaki said it. Oh, I think Chairman said it first, actually.
Okay, because the timing board
says... How did they both run the same exact time?
It says Chairman, Zaki, Phil, AJ, Terry, Horse, Kamba, Lucas, Adri, Rex, Barry, K-Dub, and Chris rounding up the field. The top four have a set of the exact same times, which is hilarious. But, yeah, I do believe it was Chairman. Oof. Man, if Zaki would have said the one more driver before. Looks like Chairman sets that time first, and then between Phil and AJ, definitely Phil. So looks like in that order, that will be your starting order for today. Is the timing board meant to do that? Whoever sets the time first is the first to pop up?
No. Well, whoever sets it first. You could just look at latest times, I reckon. The timing system has extra numbers you can't see. Whoever is first is first. Excuse me? Yeah. I'd like to talk to Phil.
Let's. I'm going to try this one more time.
Phil, do you have us this time? Guys in the booth?
Sorry, yeah, I had internet issues, but I'm back.
Okay. Damn it. See, I had such a good question. I forgot, but I think I remember now. Coming into this race, you are currently... Wait, sorry, I'm looking at the Cup standings. Oops.
7.3.
You're first. Yeah. You're in the lead. I know last season you got put in Xfinity very late, and obviously you couldn't make a championship run, but this season you've run. You're definitely looking to be able to do it. How do you think this race is going to go for you? Obviously, it's an opportunity for you to pad your points lead at Halo. Has a sub. Terry is here. Adri is here. They're obviously chasing after you. Obviously, also, it's a super speedway, so I'd guess you're holding your breath, baby. How do you feel about your chances here today?
Yeah, what you said, holding my breath. I'm not going to try to be real aggressive here or make dumb moves. Honestly, I think a lot of this race is going to be avoidance maneuvers. And... I don't know, man. It's super speedway race, and I'll try. I don't do well, I mean, I'm gonna try to do well at least for stage 1 and 2 to get some points, make top 7. But the end, I know how it always is towards the last 5-10 laps. People, how they get pushing really hard, and a lot of cautions like to come out.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's unfortunate that it has to be at a super speedway, but. Yeah, I'm rooting for you. I know last time we were here, last time you started here, you lost in a photo finish with Chris. So, maybe you can be there at the end and win it this time.
If I'm in a position like before D1, if I'm pushing my teammate, I'm not going to make a move. I'm just going to push us to the finish because I don't think it's worth trying to beat my teammate. So, but, I mean, it'll be nice to get in the playoff bye, but we'll see.
Yeah, well, yeah, of course. I mean,
yeah.
I mean, whatever you are going to do, I'm sure it'll be smart. I wish you the best of luck today.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Smart driver.
Yeah, yeah. Phil is a good guy. Phil is a good guy. He makes a lot of smart decisions. He's usually very he's usually a fun guy to race. He's a fun guy to race. I was gonna make a comment on how I drive Phil. Sometimes I drive him a little aggressively, but you know, but I have my moments. So.
Well, I think get ready.
I'm scared.
I am too. So
I really would like to put a disclaimer out that what you're about to see
does not represent the RCRA in any way. We apologize
We do really apologize in advance. We never aim to have these types of races. It's just really unfortunate that we have to do the super speedway. If it were up to me, there would be none, but it's not up to me. So, yeah, just I'm giving you a warning. Yeah. Can't say I didn't warn you.
Well, it looks like the dog has kicked us out. We're going to go ahead. Get ready here. We'll be right back after a very short commercial break, so we could set you guys up for the worst experience of life. I can't say that. We'll be right back after just a couple commercials. Stay with us though, because we're going green here at Talladega.
Quarter Pound King in the 2 for $6, only at BK.
And there you have it. McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich. This isn't just another chicken sandwich. No, it's more than that. It's the crispy chicken sandwich. From the makers of the world's most stolen fries. It's the juicy chicken sandwich. From the place that offers extra napkins for a reason. It's the tender chicken sandwich. From the creators of a sandwich phenomenon. So you won't just be biting into a chicken sandwich, you'll be biting into McDonald's new, crispy, juicy, tender chicken sandwich. Introducing McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwiches. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Introducing Wendy's new fries. Guaranteed hot and crispy, or we'll replace them. They're even preferred almost 2-to-1 over McDonald's. Get to Wendy's and try our new hot and crispy fries for yourself.
As he was finding his game, he saw possibilities to be more than a competitor, more than a champion. More than the greatest ever. He saw he could be an inspiration for all people to see possibilities.
Let's go.
That through the power of sport. There are no limits to what we can do.
You know what? Here's to going for it. And being terrible. Here's to giving it a shot, even though your shot is garbage. To being the queen of the court. Oh, maybe not this court.
Hitting nets.
To feeling the burn, even if there shouldn't be a burn to feel. To trying your best, even though your swing is the worst. Here's to going down way harder than you get back up.
Possibly one more ball.
To giving it your all. Even though you kind of suck. But you know what doesn't suck?
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here from the RCRA for the Ag Pro. Sorry, for the Ag Pro 210, ladies and gents. Welcome back. You may or may not have missed the entire national anthem, but that's alright. We're gonna be okay. Engines have fired up. We're getting ready to go here behind the pace car today. Whew. How are we doing? Any confidence at all? I'll take that as a no.
Sorry. I just made a really bad joke.
Oh dear.
To my dear friend dog. I just want to say, I truly do love. Anyways, I don't really know our point with this.
Yeah, I don't either. But as you can see here, pace car lining up, calling the drivers out by their car numbers. So let's go ahead, go over race info real quick. Here at Talladega Super Speedway for the Ag Pro 210. 23 lap stage 1, 24 lap stage 2, and 32 laps for stage 3. Track length is 2.660 miles. Last race winner here was Sky in D1 a couple weeks ago. Keys to success today. Survive. Basic. Yeah, stay alive.
That's all you gotta say, Chris.
Crash avoidance is a good skill. Good restarts can be important. I mean, they definitely can in some ways, you just again have to really avoid those wrecks. Leading is not always optimal. No, not at all. If you're gonna avoid those wrecks, don't be the leader. That's all I'm saying, man. And
I'm not ready, man.
And good luck will always win here. Be a good sportsman. Don't cry, cause this is a long race. This is a long, long race.
Oh, it's gonna go down here.
Again, it's me and Alex and both today with Coyle doing pit commentary. Alex, how you're still not doing good?
I'm scared, man. I'm scared. I'm scared for the well-being of our Xfinity truck and cup drivers in this race.
Terry might not be able to make a race for a couple weeks after this one.
I mean, that's good for complaining.
Excuse you? Hold on, I was about to pan the camera away. What's it good for? No, you finished that. What's it good for, sir?
A points lead.
Wow. A driver's
the starting order.
No. We're not changing subjects.
The starting order.
No. You're more worried about points lead than this poor kid's health. Unreal. Sacrificing his life for entertainment.
Terry is a very good team owner. I truly enjoy racing for him. I did not mean any malicious intent with what I have just said. I truly do care about his health. I just think it would be nice to have the points lead. The starting order for Talladega. Chairman Mao starts on pole, Zachy second, Phil third, AJ fourth. You got a pair of Chevys and you got a pair of Chevys and a Toyota and Ford. They got three manufacturers in the top five. Look at that. You got Austin, also was Terry, Horse in sixth, Kambuck seventh, Lucas eighth, Audrey ninth, Rex tenth, and then two Chevys, and one Toyota, Joe Gibbs Toyota, qualifying at the very back. That's Chris ATM. Doubling up on the back file, the back stretch here. We will be going green this time. Chris, I know you like to, but could I have the honor?
Oh man, I was kind of looking forward to it, but go ahead, Alex, you may. Once they get to the restart zone, it's all yours.
Thank you.
No, I don't see Aldery. I do not see Aldery. Is it just me? I do not see Aldery in the pack.
Maybe. No, he's...
He cannot.
He's gone.
I don't blame him.
I'd run too.
He has disqualified himself from the race. That'll probably lower him in points a lot, but probably for his own good. Let's be real here.
Alright, gentlemen. The pace car leads the pack out of turn 4, Talladega Super Speedway. This is a track that has had many controversial finishes before, including two photo finishes the last time trucks were here. The pace car peels off. Chairman Mao leads us to the restart zone. The flagman's gonna hold them. And as we get to the green start zone, green flag in the air. Boogity, boogity, boogity. Let's go race this big old Talladega racetrack.
Oh, a good start there from Zachy. I don't know if that was a jump or not, but we'll have to see about that one. As you can see, they're already trying to wreck behind. That's Rex on the outside there. I believe that's Chaos Bug being forced down low.
Yes, it is. You can see the pack coming down the backstretch here. The outside lane being led by the 21 Chevy, RCR Chevy. The inside lane being led by the 54. Getting a big push from Phil and a big push from Terry. They're going to survive the first lap, maybe.
Yeah, Chaos Bug there on the apron being forced down there by Rex, but for, as of right now, somehow remaining sort of calm is Rex. Oh my goodness, just barely.
Rex is
going
to Cosmetics, yeah.
Yeah,
Rex needs to be careful there. Three wide, the 23 of Lucas, almost four wide now, and one of them needs to back out of that. Looks like they're actually going to start training it here.
Oh my goodness.
Would you look at that? Talladega train
be a miracle.
Line. Lap two, no caution yet. It's getting a little squirrely back there. You can see the 18 of Rex being blocked all the way to the wall by the 29 of Tooth.
Oh my goodness,
that's his team owner.
Well, they're training, Alex.
It's a choo-choo train here at Talladega Racetrack.
Honk your horns and pull out the cargo. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not just a metro train. This is a freight train. Philadelphia,
USX.
Los Angeles.
You got an intermodal coming down the backstretch.
Oh my goodness.
Being turn three, that's Sherman Mao, your race leader, being pushed. Big push from his teammate. Oh, Phil is a great pusher. He heard him say that 12 car. He said he was going to push his teammates the whole way around. You got a Joe Gibbs, a TRD, and two RCR boys behind him. Zach, you better stay in line here.
Yeah, just a tiny bit. I want to say a car length and a half from the top four to Cam Bug in the back. See Chairman go a little bit right there. I didn't try over.
Yeah, well, the pack is starting. It looks like they're trying to get a second lane formed here, but that's not going to help. You got to stay. Look, right now, it looks like you just. I don't know. You just got to. It looks like that you got to stay organized. These guys aren't staying organized, and this is going to allow a breakaway from these top four here. It's almost like a tandem, almost, huh?
Yeah.
Has he seen this?
I am. That's actually quite amazing and satisfying to look at. I'm not going to lie with you. But you cannot.
We got the 2013 pack. Ooh, yeah, Chairman's
you can't hook onto the bumper though, Alex. You can't.
No, you got to be careful about that too, right?
Oh my goodness.
So they're getting squirrely in the back now. Phil maybe looking inside. No.
I think he's gonna try holding.
Oh, maybe he is. No, he's going. Oh. Chairman Mao.
Chairman
see
makes
ya.
A mistake. Yeah.
And now we have to see, what are the Chevys going to do? Are the Chevys going to push him? I think they will. Ooh,
oh,
Terry's going to have to lift. Oh,
Terry.
His teammate lets him come back up. A little too generous from Zachy there, I'd say.
Yeah. Don't worry.
Because now Zachy's going to get shuffled out. Oh my goodness.
Chairman.
Where is he going?
Yeah, Alex, I know you're laughing in your
maybe
head right
he
now.
Didn't see it.
Yeah, you're laughing in your head right now, Alex. Wait, what did you saw Chairman do?
I mean, chair, no comment. we proceed. Phil going to control these lanes here. Maybe he wants to give his teammate some help.
That opens
here
up
got.
The inside, though.
Three manufacturers fighting for the lead here. Zachy tries to move inside on Lucas. Lucas is having none of it. No thank you.
Oh, my goodness. Lucas up there. Jurassic World car. You see Chairman.
I must say, I've never seen a Super Speedway race go this green for this long in a while in this league.
Longer the Atlanta race today for NASCAR.
Yeah. Don't even speak about that race. That happened. So now you have three manufacturers battling for the lead here. You got a pair of Chevys, a Ford, and two Toyotas. With a Chevy falling behind and a Ford behind that. And you know what? The Cup Series...
Lucas!
Driver,
he comes back up on
driver. This is where... This is the thing that Lucas is aggressive at these racetracks, and honestly, I can kind of understand why. Ooh, Rex trying to poke his nose underneath Lucas there. That is no bueno, sir.
He's completely inside Lucas. And he pushes him up the track.
No, that's getting quoted. No. Sorry about that one.
Alex.
You're getting your own quarter channel for that one as well.
Rex on the apron. Don't come back up. Okay, he's good. Oh, I think quarter.
Okay, well that 18 car's got to get off that apron. There you go. It's a little foul choo 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 train here at Talladega. Honestly. Is it bad to say that I'm kind of liking it?
No, I'm loving this.
How about a turn four? Look at that line of cars go. They're going to come to the tri-oval. The 21 is Aki looking high on his teammate.
Man, this is choo-choo.
Yeah, it is choo-choo. Sometimes that's what you got to do. Oh,
whoa.
So you can see there, the start-finish lag really does get some people out of shape.
Yeah, it does. AJ's going to fall all the way back. Unfortunate for him. He's going to fall back.
What happened to Phil? Phil has gone all the way back there, too.
Yeah, after he tried to help Chairman on the outside, he had no help out there. And oh my goodness, look at this. Oh, they're going to leave Lucas out to dry. That was a brilliant move. That was a brilliant move.
Three Chevys coming to the lead. Lucas is going to try and slot down. And there he goes.
That was great. That was good. That was pretty good, though. That was close. It was tight. That's for sure.
I'm telling you. Chris.
No, that's you, not me. Zaki gets forced out of line. See what happens. Are they going to let him back in somehow? Is Terry going to let off the gas?
Oh, that's going to be a wreck. Guess. Come on, man. It's only lap 8. Well, you got to be thinking now, pitch strategies, huh? Because, I mean, this is running green the whole way, maybe.
Well, I'm looking at Lucas's stats here.
And look at those two Chevys just going all the way to the back.
Unfortunately for them, but Lucas. Oh, Lucas is going to try to the inside. Inside. The inside of Barry. He's going to be able to make that move work. Barry set up too much entering 3. And now Lucas.
Oh, Lucas trying to go underneath Terry for the lead. And Zaki got the hell out of there. Zaki, that's bad, man. You got three shots. Did you see what Zaki just did? He's not making friends on this racetrack.
He's going to fall quite a ways back, though. As we come to lap 9. No, normally, if I was feeling like it, I would post a commercial because that would be pro broadcasting and that would be professional. But I'm loving this. I don't care what Fox says. Don't hire me. I don't care. I don't care if I'm going to be a commentator when I grow up for Fox or NBCSN. This is amazing.
I come back at this, and you're talking about commentating on Fox.
I'm sorry to cut you off there, Chairman. Lucas slides up. Chairman set up in the Rex, and Lucas set up in the Chairman.
Let me tell you, Zaki had been hung. Oh my goodness, have you ever? Barry,
no,
you got held on all the drivers.
Comes up on his brother.
The JTG. Oh, Lucas to the lead of the race. What did I tell you?
Yeah, Terry got left out to dry there. Fortunate for him.
And now Terry is going to be the one again. Oh, they're going to be three wide. Nearly. Hold on, we're at the start-finish line, drivers. Lucas moves outside. Questionable. Ooh,
no!
Lucas, you can't do that, mate.
You can't do that one. And Chairman and him are going to fall all the way back.
Well, it's not over for Lucas here. They're going to be three wide off the turn.
Ooh. Sure about that. Chairman's trying to force his way back up in the back. Unfortunate for him. But
Well, now we're going to have two lines of cars working here. And...
Oh, yeah.
I don't think it's going to go very far for very long. Terry's making it three wide. He doesn't want to be up there. I think Terry's going to have to slot in behind this 10 car and just stay Larry.
Yeah,
yes, he is.
Exactly.
Here comes
does.
His teammate. And
oh
Lucas.
My goodness.
Lucas you
got to
see that, man. You got to see that.
He dorting. That's for sure.
That is for sure. Now here they come through the quad oval. This is a... What is this? Is this a tri-oval? What is it? It's a curve.
It's a tri-oval. I can guarantee you it's a tri-oval.
Right, well, the tri-oval, not a quad-oval. It does not look like a quadriplatic shape. Whatever. That. Anyways. Now the back, I'm telling you, we have had 11
green flag laps.
Green flag racing.
Alex
laps.
Had a loss before.
And I have to say, I'm impressed.
You know, while we have the time, Alex, would you like to go... Whoa!
That's a big shove from Austin, and that kind of got demonic, or horse all out of shape there.
While we have the time, it is pretty calm. You want to do a scheme review with me?
A scheme review?
Yeah, I mean...
Oh, we
might not have time,
man.
In a second.
That's a bad move from Rex.
He's in the grass! But now that we have the time, let's start from... Top to bottom, so Rex, the scheme was made by me. I thought I did a good job on the scheme. It was very hard to render it, but thank you, Phil, for that, for helping me there. I mean, in my opinion, that's a 7 out of 10 for me. 7 out of 10.
Yeah, it's not a bad scheme, that's for sure. I'd give it a 7 out of 10. I can agree with that. 7.5 out of 10.
Being generous.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
Now, Terry, there goes Rex. Yeah, just did not have
to. All the way to the outside, yeah.
But now the Terry. Dude wipes car. Alex, did you make this car? I did.
Oh, look at that run the 18's gonna get, but you can't carry it if you don't have any help.
Unfortunately for him.
Ooh, that Toyota's getting. No, it's getting a little squirrely here now. And you just wait till the end of this stage. Every stage at Talladega is like a race finish.
You know, they'll be good on tires, but not on fuel. That's for sure.
Terry, that's gonna be close. Terry. Can't do that. Yep, Terry's gonna be shuffled. His teammate's gonna leave to help him, and Rex is also coming with a run, so maybe he can get to the bumper here. I highly doubt
it.
Yeah,
I doubt it.
So they're gonna be on the outside on their own. It'd be nice to see somebody hop out and give that 18 car some help, but it looks like they're just comfortable running it single file for now.
I would definitely be comfortable too. I would not want to risk a wreck for being too aggressive on lap 13 here, that's for sure.
Yeah, so look at these two RCR cars. They're keeping it organized, and they're kind of proving, like, you can definitely get a second line going. You just have to be organized. And you can look at that. Oh, Zachy. That's going to hurt them, their momentum a bit. But look, two cars, they're making it work. I mean, they're going to get past now because they have, like, half the field on the inside.
Well, they have AJ come to the outside, actually. Maybe Camba. I'm not too sure. He looked like it for a second.
Well, we're going to be... That 10 car needs to keep going.
Oh, Horse!
Three wide now. Three
Horse
wide.
Horse is going to lose his lead because of that. Three wide.
It's the RCR boys on the outside. Hold your line, drivers. Here we come. Down the back stretch. Three wide. Almost four wide for the lead. Terry coming on the outside with his teammate. You got three lines here at Talladega Raceway. All you got to do is use the lanes, boys. They're painted for a reason. Stay in your lanes.
Yeah, all it takes is just one bad entry into the corner, and you're screwed, man. So you can see Rex gonna hop up in line.
There you go. The 10 kind of go outside. That kind of hurt the 21 of. Oh, this is where it gets bad though. At the start finish.
Oh, because of the lag.
Oh no!
Okay, please,
we're gonna have some
issue.
This is gonna be a wreck. It's gonna be a wreck.
Come on, they know. Look, see, the RCR boy is going to the outside there.
Okay.
Good,
hey.
Good. Hey, that was okay.
We got three lines at this Omega racetrack. Have you ever?
No, I have never. Oh, not even in iRacing. And I'm getting demoted to rookie.
Oh yeah, so the RCR boys are gonna.
Oh, Zachy! Oh, Zachy almost ruined it for everybody there. Oh, that was close. Then the RCR boys fall to the back a little. Terry coming off of two stage wins from yesterday at London, and the second place podium finish.
Yes. That 21 car getting all out of shape.
Yeah, he is.
And this proves, like, Zachy was organized. They were organized and they were keeping up. Now they're not organized and now they're going to struggle to keep up with the line. That's the 50, the 88 of K-Dub going all the way to the back.
Yeah, server lag for him. He's going to come back up on Chairman Mao. Almost. But server lag kind of coming across the stripes. Ladies and gentlemen, we're on lap 16 here. No cautions. And I hope we're not giving the commentators curse. I should have my cross on right now.
These RCR boys, they're sharing this lane!
I think
this is when they have had enough,
yeah.
They've tried it for a long time, and it was fun for a little bit, experimented with it, and now they're saying it's enough.
Still in the lead, unless he gets into the apron here. He went low, he's gonna come back up on Barry, though. And looks like...
And who's that? Is that...
That's Barry!
Chris ATM, look at him. Bad day for him in Halo's car. I mean, that's going to be destructive to his points lead.
Oh yeah, just
or not points lead. I did tell Halo that.
Whoa! Look at those RCR boys going all the way to the outside. They're going, and look too. There's Kamba to the outside. It's a 4v2, Alex.
Yes, it is. For once, you you don't see the outside lane training like this, but Chevy teammates, Chevy manufacturers, look here, they all come on the outside. Look at that Chevy train going.
Oh my goodness. They are coming in hot from the outside too. They got the momentum off the corner.
They are coming in hot. Here they come. Look. As we know, the inside lane is the quickest way around the track. The 56 is going to bring them all down low.
Lucas has no help.
Lucas does not have any help. And if I'm the Chevys, I'm kicking it outside. I'm getting this guy before the field gets up here. Train it around the outside. Lucas, where are you going, man? Chrissy, I don't like this. Oh, the 56-18's got to hold their line. Yeah. Stay in the lanes, people. They're painted for a reason.
It looks like 23 is leading the pack
underneath. And here comes the 29 to the outside. And here comes the 56. Oh. That's bad.
No, get outside, Barry. Go outside, Barry. Go outside.
That's naughty.
Screaming his head off right now. That's for sure. As Lucas goes to the inside, shows him the corner power once, shows him again. Oof, getting tight. The RCR cars, Chevys, just trying to work together.
Holy crap, and here they come to the lead of the race!
No, still Lucas.
The 56
wheels. Oh, yeah, lag. Unfortunate for him. But he's going to lose all his momentum. I'm not sure.
Right. Just let off, man. Get back in line with your team.
You know, Alex, they're at 30% tires and 200 milliliters of fuel. Are they going to be able to make it to the end?
I don't think they are, and I think the person that pits, we gotta start thinking about coming to pit road here.
Because remember, it closes on lap 22 as well. Yeah, it does, because pit closed with 2 to go.
Could you imagine if the entire field ran out of gas?
It would be $40 per hour. Alright, let's see. Oh, here Lucas. Comes Lucas! There we go. Almost speeds, though. But that gives the RCR boys the lead. Whoa, Rex, all sorts of out of shape. Now, Alex, I think they're going to come down pit road this time by.
I think they're going to have to. These Chevys, they had it organized on the outside lane, but you can see Terry and Zachy hopping down low. Let's see. I think we are going to have some information from the pit road reporter. I believe he is going to be on pit road. He's not here right now. Hopefully he does come back. We gotta wonder, what are they taking, gas and fuel?
But, hold on. It's unfortunate, though.
Lucas
is not gonna have any help out pit lane either, so...
No, he's gonna get swallowed up.
That's...
But he made it a good strategy call to pit first. But here come the Chevys, out of turn 4.
They should. What's gonna happen here?
I think everyone's coming. Yeah, we got half the field, almost everyone coming. Look at them dive into the pit road. Have you ever?
When's the last time
you've seen green flag pit stops on a super speedway?
Now that gives Rex the lead. They're going to have to come in this time, though. 100%.
And hold on.
Hold your horses. Rex has 200 milliliters of fuel left. Still.
Do you think he's going to try and push it?
Yes, he could definitely push it.
I don't know. Do you remember the last time Rex ran out of fuel at Daytona truck race?
I think it's a war. Yeah, look. He's letting off on the backstretch. He's letting off. Oh, look at this, and now him and Phil are tandem drafting. That is unbelievable.
Wow. They're going to try and do it. You think they're going to try and do it?
I think they can do it.
They got to come this time.
No, they can. Look, Rex is still letting off.
They're not going in!
This is unbelievable! The race of the century! I think they could do it, though. They could definitely do it.
This is an amazing strategy call, and it's going to...
I think it's going to pay off. It's going to be, like, close, man. But I think it's going to pay off. Pits are closed. But now, listen. This is what Rex has to do.
If you're not on pit lane, you're not on pit lane. Those pits are closed.
Yeah. They are at 200 milliliters, though. It was going to come down to the last second.
This is crazy. I think they got it.
Yeah, Rex has been letting off on the backstretch. I want to go in the team comm, see what they're saying.
This is an amazing strategy call from Rex. It's kind of amazing, and I have to say, if he wins this stage, it's going to be to the wire. They're going to be to the wire on fuel. Here come the Chevys. They're not going to be even close.
You know, Alex, now that I think about it, they still have not dropped from 200 milliliters, even Phil. They, like, And Phil's been on the gas the whole time as well, so I'm kind of wondering here.
Nope, he just got to 100. He's gonna have just enough. Yeah,
Rex
is at 100 milliliters. Rex is gonna finish his stage on the. But the question is he gonna have enough fuel to pace?
Oh no!
Because if he runs out of gas, he's done.
That's right. That is right. So that's another thing. You know, honestly, I think he did make the right call. Actually, I really think he can make it back. He's gonna get a stage point at least here. Well, let's see.
I'm kind of amazed that this worked out for them. That is an amazing strategy call.
Alex, are we forgetting that this was a green flag stage at a super speedway?
It was a green flag stage.
And
you can see everybody has been absolutely caught out on strategy. The Toyotas are gonna come to the line. Rex is your stage winner, and I have to wonder how much fuel does he have left in that tank? That thing's running on fumes. That thing's gotta be running on fumes.
Anyway, yeah, he immediately lets off too.
Is that thing running on fumes or what?
I did not hear that.
Is that thing running on fumes or what?
It's running on that box in the back, you know what I mean?
Oh, you got a box? Oh. You got like a small jerry can in the back, or?
Yeah, I do. I have to, here now and then I get my robotic arm and I plug it in, if you know what I mean.
Wow, I'm kind of amazed, how did you make that strategy call?
I was just saving, to be honest with you. Last five laps, maybe at like lap 18, 19, I was saving fuel the entire time, letting off in the turns and whatnot.
So. Wow, well, good for you, I have to say. Well, I think you're gonna lose lots of positions on the pit strategy here because of it, but good for you. Goodbye.
It's a suit. Oh, can I not respond to that?
Oh, no, you can. Sorry.
It's kind of a super speedway, so, I mean, if I lose positions in, I really don't care. It's not that hard to get back up to the front, so.
Right.
Are the pits open?
I think they're bunching the field up, so it will not be open this time.
I need to start saving fuel, then. 50 fuel. All right, well, thank you for the interview. Yeah.
Good luck.
Oh, my goodness. Rear ends.
I tell you what, that, a fully green... A fully green. That's naughty. That's naughty. Who's in that 42 car?
That would be Campbell. But no Rex. You can see on the bottom of your screen 0 milliliters.
Yeah, of course it's rounded, right? So he's like you said, he's got 50 in the tank.
Yeah. So.
He's
gonna have to ask for a push. Let's see how much Chairman has. Maybe he'll ask Chairman to get up. Chairman has more than him. So, I don't know. Get low on tires too as well. It's absolutely crazy.
Yeah, that was pretty amazing, huh?
That was, I can't believe it.
I have to commend all the drivers. That was some pretty good super speedway racing. Rex is like, Phil, you better push me to the pit road, man. he's gonna run out on pit road for sure, you know?
That would be unreal.
If he runs out of gas, is he DNF?
Well, the car goes like 40 miles per hour.
Right. So, I mean, he'd lose like time on pit road. I think Phil is, but I think he's out.
You know, I think they should take a speeding penalty, in my opinion. They should have, like, speeded it down pit road, taking a speeding penalty, and just coast into the boxes, you know what I mean? But, ladies and gentlemen, it is my duty and my honor to announce Rex has done it. The perfect strategy. I am in disbelief. Quite literal disbelief. See here, however, the race off of pit road. Is that going to be? Yes, it is. That's horse off of pit road first, followed by Rex, Terry, Zachy, Lucas, AJ, Chris, K-Dub. Phil has the green light, but it's not going. Is it going to be Kambug off of pit road? Okay, I'm
wrong.
I don't know what's up with Phil. I think might have not taken something. Barry comes out. So you can Cheerman at least get one position on Phil here. And off goes Phil. And rounding up the pack will be Cheerman. Green this time, folks. Alex, do you think we could do it again?
I don't know.
I cannot believe we had no cautions at.
He's driving the base car.
I hope we have competence this race.
I hope so too.
See here, coming back.
I hope so too.
Coming back.
Oh, getting ready to start the second stage here. We'll see what happens.
Of course, leads us.
On the reach. Oh.
Sorry, go ahead.
You go ahead. No, you can go ahead.
Okay. So, horse is going to lead us here. To the dropping of the green flag. Let's see here. Does he get a good jump? Not really. He does not get a good jump. Rex, oh my goodness.
It's hard to get a good jump on that inside lane.
On the inside lane it is. Horse pushes Terry down low onto the apron. Oh my gosh. See Chris, again, having issues. Man, I didn't want to forget this race. It looks like we have reversed back to 20. Now back to 24, but we are green again. And it's Rex who does lead us. He's gonna move down to block that inside line. Let's see if we get two lines here again, Alex.
Yeah,
Let's see, Rex. Still out in the lead here. He's got Zachy right behind him. Followed by Terry, Lucas, and it appears... I want to say Caleb. Yeah, it says, oh, there goes Zachy! And up goes Rex! Through goes Terry! See Rex get forced off to that outside line there. Lucas back to the inside line.
The boss is yelling at me here.
Oh dear, oh dear. It's Terry who leads them out of four, but directly on his bumper is Lucas. Whoa. Looking to the outside now is Canbug. Is anybody else gonna go with him? I doubt it. I think he's gonna drop all the way back because of that.
Oh, Lucas!
Whoa, look out! Look out!
Look out! I'm blow up.
Still Lucas to lead us. Rex.
Fairly quiet. Towards the heart of the outside wall, blue tire. Look out.
Phil on the back of the pack. Still trying to recover from it. I shouldn't say recover because he was pushing Rex. But I guess you could say recover from being perhaps naked on fuel and tires. Barry's in mid-pack. He's had a good run today.
Yeah.
Oh.
AJ for Barry. Who needs Canva? T- Terry, Lucas, AJ, Barry, Cam, Zaki, Rex, K-Dub, Phil, Horse, Chairman, and Chris. Chris, again, having the worst runs of his life, I assume. But otherwise, very calm race so far. Really good. Very glad it's been a calm race. Anyways, we're gonna go ahead, go to side by side here, folks. We'll be right back after just a couple of messages from our sponsors.
Quarter Pound King and the 2 for $6 only at BK.
And there you have it. McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich. This isn't just another chicken sandwich. No, it's more than that. It's the crispy chicken sandwich. From the makers of the world's most stolen fries. It's the juicy chicken sandwich. From the place that offers extra napkins for a reason. It's the tender chicken sandwich. From the creators of a sandwich phenomenon. So you won't just be biting into a chicken sandwich, you'll be biting into McDonald's new, crispy, juicy, tender chicken sandwich. Introducing McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwiches. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Introducing Wendy's new fries. Guaranteed hot and crispy, or we'll replace them. They're even preferred almost 2-to-1 over McDonald's. Get to Wendy's and try our new hot and crispy fries for yourself.
As he was finding his game, he saw possibilities to be more than a competitor, more than a champion. More than the greatest ever. He saw he could be an inspiration for all people to see possibilities.
Let's go.
That through the power of sport. There are no limits to what we can do.
You know what? Here's to going for it. And being terrible. Here's to giving it a shot, even though your shot is garbage. To being the queen of the court. Oh, maybe not this court.
Hitting nets.
To feeling the burn, even if there shouldn't be a burn to feel. To trying your best, even though your swing is the worst. Here's to going down way harder than you get back up.
Possibly one more ball.
To giving it your all. Even though you kind of suck. But you know what doesn't suck? Trying to do something you've never done before. That doesn't suck at all. Not even a little.
We'll be right back.
Hi, Phil Swift here for Flex Tape. The super strong waterproof tape that can instantly patch, bond, seal, and repair. Flex Tape's triple thick adhesive welds itself to the surface.
Hello, ladies and gents, we are back here, at Talladega. Getting ready to round up the stage. Coyle, you have some pit reports.
Okay, my pit reports right now. So, TRD and Jogan's Racing and Phil, they said they were immediately committed from the start to not stop during that last stage. They just felt like how the pack was racing, they kind of just felt like they didn't need to stop, and he said he didn't obviously have to save a lot. The next stage, they kind of just decided on strategy as the race moves on, and he said the car feels a little balanced, but feels like a little tight on the entry. RCR felt like they were committed to pitting at the start of that stage. They said also the car was pretty balanced and fine. And then one, a little scare for Chris there. He said possibly he was very close on fuel, some people said. But yeah, he was able to nurse it back to third row.
Thank you, Coyle. Alright, folks, real quick, we're going to go ahead and switch streams. I'll be right back, but we're going to go ahead and switch streams real quick so you don't miss any of the action. So if I end the stream and it says you're on the end screen, go ahead, just refresh your screen and the new stream should be there. We'll be right back. Stand by.